I wouldn't say it's particularly dead. I would say that it's not popular.
You know, it's not dead. It's not deceased.
Elements of rock, I would say, still exist in the music scene, particularly in Sydney, I can't say globally.
Rock was pop a while ago, and then now it's just something else, but it's still there.
I feel like, yeah, rock has just taken a backseat.
As a nobody who knows nothing about music, I say it's not popular at the moment. Your cavern eyes are praying, your scarlet lips have sent a sales pitch for the circus in your mind.
Scoot the Loot, we met in around early high school in the music program at school where we were assigned doing performances together, and we just sort of kept playing together, kept playing assignments and came tighter and tighter and formed a band.
What would you say is Scoot the Loot's main inspiration when it comes to the sound of your music?
Oh, I'd definitely say Arctic Monkeys is a big one, and also Red Hot Chili Peppers. A lot of those songs we've done, and it's had a big influence on our music as a whole.
Is rock music dead?
I wouldn't think so. I think people are always looking to have a good time jumping around, and the energy of music like rock music can supply that in bunches. I think rock could definitely come back. One artist just needs to come through who's mainstream enough to get everybody involved.
It depends. If it's recontextualized, there are new sounds and whatnot, perhaps it could reach a mainstream audience. But I'd say older, more traditional rock is died out from this culture.
Do people still care about rock music?
Oh yeah, definitely. People will always care about rock music, I feel. But it will inevitably start to lose popularity over time. Is it dead? No, it's not dead. It's always gonna be alive in some form or another, whether it's been changed or evolved, but the core concepts of rock I don't think will die out.
I was drawn to community radio because I wanted to be a comedian, and I thought that'd be a nice way to like sort of boost my profile and get the name out there. But when I started volunteering first at a Northern Beaches radio station in Terry Hills, I just sort of found myself falling in love with Australian music and Sydney music in general, and it sort of snowballed from there to here.
When did your relationship with music begin?
I mean, like most people, it sort of began in high school, but I think it really started to develop into something quite a bit more serious as I got involved here at FBI. I first started in the music library, so like cataloging all the music. Then I started helping out the music team, and I think it was sort of being on that front line of like the newest material that was coming in and being able to put my ear to it, and just being able to sort of see the intrinsic cultural and musical quality.
Is rock music dead?
Nah, I don't think it is. I mean, if you look at just Sydney alone, which is kind of now the only thing that I can really speak on with terribly much authority, there's a lot of really great bands out there. There's this really wide palette of sounds just with, you know, three dudes playing guitars, maybe one or two singing and then a drummer, that you can get so many different sounds out of. I don't think that there is a new rock. I think the cultural impact that it had, and the way that, you know, something like Beatlemania, just like it was a thing, like people, like an entire country falling in love with one band, like that's never gonna happen again. You'll never have an audience that is that unified ever again. I don't think that there is a new rock just because there's so many alternatives.